I'm Cheryl Cole, and I'm about to show you what life has been like for me on my first ever solo tour. On stage, off duty, and behind the scenes.
To the outside world, it's all glitz and glamour, and actually, it's hard.
Dinesh, would you open the door now? She's just about to run in.
Ever on the path, in 6 inch heels, how about that one?
For the past 2 months, I've been rehearsing in LA, putting the show together back in London, and playing the UK's biggest arena venues. Along the way, I've had some incredible highs and faced some major setbacks.
This is serious, it's his life, it's his livelihood.
And I'm gonna share it all with you.
I think that window's open.
Glam good.
Yeah, one final check. Let the camera shows me.
You, Tony.
Oh, yes.
I have toured before many times with Girls Aloud, played the same arenas that I'll be playing solo, but I've never done this alone. So it's quite a strange feeling. All I want is to have the best show I can have. So it's gonna be big, very big.
I haven't even drunk coffee.
Anxiety?
Coffee gives you anxiety.
Coffee?
Yeah, I haven't had coffee. Coffee. I've got to go for coffee.
Italian New York.
Yeah, no. Some cold cuts. Go down the deli.
I need to get to the point of why I have anxiety.
Need to what?
You know, when you go through and then you figure out why it is happening.
It's totally natural for you to have anxiety before your concert starts. Your brain must be thinking, what's that bit, what's that bit? I've got to do this. So you don't feel settled at the moment. But in a few days, when you get into production rehearsals, and you get on that stage and you can go, right, I've got 5 days to just figure this all. But at the moment, it's all just a little bit fragmented. So what you must remember is that you are in total control of this. This is your show. So therefore, if you want to go over anything, you want to re-practice anything, you want anything, basically, Cheryl, you have to say so.
Do you ever have anxiety?
Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah, all the time.
I promise you. That's good to know.
All the time.
You feel really vulnerable when you're doing something so big for the first time. It's my show. At the end of the day, it's going to be my name that's up there in the lights. It's going to be my show that's reviewed, you know, and it's all on you. So it has to be exactly right, and that pressure is intense.
I'm so focused on making my tour the best it can possibly be, so I've come to Los Angeles to put together the perfect team. With the dancers cast, we've got just 2 weeks to perfect the choreography before heading home for the tour.
It's such an excitement going into the first day of rehearsal because you're learning new choreography, you feel inspired. People are hearing your music for the first time. People are watching each other for the first time and becoming a team and knowing that we're going to have to be together for a long time. It's just an excitement. It's the best bit, really.
Take it back, boom, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 8. This song was absolutely massive in the UK, and the whole theme of it was being like a soldier.
To do it all, you have to have people around you that you believe in, that are talented in their field, and that you ultimately trust. I've worked with Beth since the very, very early days of Girls Aloud, and she has the British element.
But it will say my name, baby.
Mm-hmm.
How do you think I feel?
Mm-hmm.
Then we have Fatima as creative director. Slightly bonkers, but I love that.
That goes all the way down, and they put stairs up, but they put that strong light that comes like a light, it's like, shoo! Yes, from the ground, and then you guys come marching up in silhouette.
It's powerful.
It's so powerful. It's dope. I love it.
And then I have my dancers.
So da 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 keep going.
Having American dancers was important for me in terms of the boost they give. And the culture difference just adds something new.
In the English language, doesn't A have two sounds?
Yes.
What the two sounds does A make?
Tomato, ba.
No, A, not the tomato.
Tomato. Tomato.
Tomato.
Tomato.
Tomato.
So ah. So
tomato.
Tomato.
Yeah. Tomato.
Potato?
Potato.
Potato. Potato. You say potato? Nice. Got him. Exactly. You guys would be an English teacher's nightmare.
Trey is a dancer. He is my boyfriend. And the rest you can figure out for yourself.
Potato.
That's what the song's all about, isn't it?
Let's call
the
whole thing potato, we say potato, we say tomato, potato, tomato.
Potato, potato,
how's
tomato.
How's about you fuck off?
Being in LA, the sun's shining. Everybody's a stranger. Nobody knows or cares who I am. It's just relieves a lot of the everyday stress of normal life that I just don't need when I'm trying to focus. But with such an important tour ahead, it's hard not to think about the reality of what I'm about to take on.
It's not an easy job. The easy bit's getting on stage and doing what you love. Everything else is hard. With Girls Aloud, you're protected because it's a big brand of people. Whereas with me, it's just me. So if the show sucks, it's just me that sucks.
Our time in LA will soon be coming to an end, and there's just one last chance to unwind before the tour starts. It's my little brother Gary's birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
I love people around that feel like familiar, feel like they're there for the right intention, the right reason. Everybody has the same end goal, which is just for this to be as good and big and as successful as it possibly can be. And I don't know, there's a loyalty, there's a trust, there's a love, a genuine love. And we're all in it together, we're a team. And it's soon time for the team to head back to London for the final tour preparations.
Oh, aeroplane, incoming.
But just getting to the airport is a reminder of what I'll be facing when I get home.
Hey, okay, Dinesh, would you open the door now? She's just about to run in. Okay, there you are. Perfect. Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Thanks, Mario. Did you get her? Did you get her?
No! Oh,
yeah!
Damn! You guys won this time.
We won!
Fans always like, she's a ninja, how does she get from one place to the other without us saying it? And I'm like, because I outrun the pass in 6-inch heels, how about that one?
I was trapped in the back of the car.
Gary, I outrun.
Well, let's go. Did you outrun him in heels as well?
In heels.
Oh, yeah, that's a talent, actually. That is a talent.
Personally, when I was going through stuff, and they were following and in my face all the time when you were already going through her, that's what I associate them with. So now, I do anything I can to avoid them getting a picture because it's to their benefit, but it gives me anxiety. So the fact that I just beat him is another high five. We do it regular, but my heart is beating like crazy.
Sleepy time for Team Co.
Yeah, I'm tired. This is how you prevent jet lag.
Enjoying your Baileys.
I'm about to hit the road with my first ever solo tour. We're in London for the pre-production rehearsals where the entire show needs to be set to the stage.
48 hours.
48 hours?
To get it together.
Oh, you mean
12-hour days. What did you have to say that for?
Because it's true. It's
that makes it sound like 2 days.
It is 2 days.
The full stage has been set up in a studio, and after weeks of planning, I'm desperate to see what it looks like in the flesh.
I've imagined it for a long time, but when you actually see it, it's kind of breathtaking. It's exciting. It feels real now. It feels like I'm really going on tour, like it's not just in my head anymore.
So far, we've only practiced the routines in a rehearsal space. But it's going to be a lot different on a 20-foot, three-tiered stage, especially with the opener I've got in mind.
So the swan dive is basically me plucking up the courage to launch myself with no safety equipment into the arms of four dancers. It's the scariest thing ever.
Girl! Cheryl, listen, you're the shit if you
fucking,
do this.
Honestly.
You're the fucking shit.
So, oh my God. All I can see is the next level stage, so I know I'm only falling 6. But when I look, I can see 20. So I have to poke her face and suck it up and jump off there.
Once you get over that.
Yeah. Shemaine, do without music, please. Why did you gasp?
No, just that was breathing.
Oh, my God. Whatever. She shit herself. She shit herself.
No,
yes, you did.
I was trying to show you.
Shoot me. I heard you.
Because she was known for doing the swan dive off the voice performance, it makes total sense to bring it to the arena stage.
And when I saw it on YouTube, I was like, whoa, did she just do that? I was like, wow, she has balls. And we gotta do that for our show. All right, damn it, let's go. Here we go, 5, 6.
Okay, now I've got shaky legs, because so what am I gonna do?
Jump off.
Let's do the routine, we'll do this after.
Got it.
No.
Yes, babe. This is too much now, it's just all got a different situation.
We'll just take it from the rise, everybody, from the rise.
When the adrenaline kicks in and she knows she's got to do it, she'll do it. But while she's got an option to not have to do it, she won't. Maybe if we get her a cookie, she might do it. Right, first places, please. Full out, thank you. Cheryl's now in.
There is a presence with Trey. He gives 100% on that stage every single time. He doesn't know any other percentage.
What are you gonna eat today? What are you gonna eat today? What do you wanna talk about? You can talk about anything.
I just look. Don't let me look at you in your own zone.
I'm looking at my fans.
There's a stronger connection and a chemistry that you wouldn't have with any other dancer. Have that relationship is rare. To be able to have that with you and share those moments is pretty special, actually.
Hold it there, it'll take a couple of minutes.
Did you know that we're getting married?
When?
In the winter.
I didn't know that.
I'll show you right next.
Famous,
huh?
Cheryl's winter wedding.
They said congratulations. She congratulated us.
I can't handle that.
It still blows my mind the amount of lies and rubbish that is written about me. Crazy stuff that somebody in an office has actually thought of that morning and written down as a fact.
Except for winter wedding.
I think it's so
funny. How does that happen?
They just
how do people do that to you? Like,
yeah.
It's all new for Trey, you know, it's crazy to him. I've experienced it for 10 years. I get it, but it's more hurtful when the media intrude on my loved ones. They didn't ask for this. They didn't want that. They just want a normal life with their family.
Stop it. Horrible. Stop it.
There's nothing I can do about it, except feel extremely frustrated at the fact that they're hurting people I love. That's hard.
Final day of pre-production rehearsals. Our last chance to run through the show before we head to Belfast for the opening night.
It's the most stressful time because you have a set amount of time to make sure everyone's safety is correct. The pyro's going up, so you can't stand there because you're going to get set on fire. People are hurting themselves. People are being injured.
I landed so hard into the stage and that, like, threw my joint off.
People are not fitting in their costumes or they don't quite look right.
The guy's looks are not working at all.
I hate his guts.
She looks fabulous and they look cheap.
Yeah.
I can't do a dress run because everything's not ready.
This is our dress rehearsal. Four people in clothes.
It is insane. A sound problem, a costume problem, a dancer problem. I mean, that's why you rehearse, is so that if there's gonna be problems, they're gonna present themselves before the show. I'm glad it's not during. It's just mentally and physically exhausting, but there is no avoiding it, which is even more annoying. You can't press fast forward, you can't. You just have to go through the process.
Which one do you want? Oh,
fat.
Do you want a cup?
No, thanks. Thank you. I think I win something, don't I? Because I've got a red pole.
You win every day. You're a winner.
There's just so much stuff that you don't even think about when you go to a concert that you have to consider. There's just different issues for everyone. If it was perfect, I'd be worried. Well, if it's still like this on Wednesday, I'm going home.
After 4 days of rehearsals, we're ready to take my show on the road. The whole set needs to be broken down and shipped to Belfast. Because in 2 days' time, I'll be headlining my first ever solo tour. In Belfast, the stage, costumes and choreography are all ready to go. But we're facing a major setback.
So yesterday at rehearsals, Trey took a fall. He unfortunately hurt his knee, which didn't seem like a big issue at the time. But it looks like it's worsened overnight and is swollen and actually needs some attention.
How was Trey's knee?
I don't know, he's still at the hospital.
How was it for him when he woke up?
So.
Trey has been taken to hospital for an emergency MRI scan. But with just 11 hours before the show, I have no choice but to head straight to the venue.
This is serious, he's nervous, he's, you know what I mean? It's his life, it's his livelihood, it's what he does. Be like me losing my voice, what the hell would I do? Because if he can't do the show, that's one thing. But if he can't dance or he has to be operated on, it takes him 6 months to get back.
So it's like got excess fluid on it and it's bruised inside. So it's just a case of resting, but they don't know how long for.
Lily, oh, what the hell? Does Chomp, he's gonna stand in.
I'll tell him that.
It's so typical, isn't it? I've never, ever, never been a dancer then. Never. All the doors.
Never.
Even the big girls allowed on 36 dates. Never. And the thing is he's upset with himself because I asked him to not backflip. About 5 times, I said to him, please don't backflip. Please don't backflip. You're not a tricker. I don't like it.
Trey can't do it now, so I'm stepping in there. I'm pretty much learning his entire part right now this morning.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3.
He must be gutted, because I haven't seen him yet. And he's been working so hard towards doing this, and obviously he'd want to do opening night for Cheryl just because of the incredible bond between them as well as two people. Everything else you can just hope to get away with, but the swan dive is a danger. And Trey did the swan dive with her. So therefore, that's the major thing that needs rehearsing, because you can't mess with that.
So on top of first night nerves, I'm a dancer down. I have to do the swan dive, then I don't have Trey. I don't have the support I need, or I feel I need. And it all feels too real. Because the show must go on and there is nothing I can do about any of it right now, except go out there and perform. It's rolling.
Showtime!
There's people running up and down the corridors. Dancers are warming up. I'm dressed. He says, pulling off one side of me hair. Spraying us with hairspray. Somebody's clipping something to the back. But I am not there with them. I'm in a zone on my way to the stage. I can hear the audience screaming. Mill is shouting, are you ready? To which I say, I don't know. I don't know. I am trying to figure out a way of getting down the stairs if I lose me nerve to swan dive. I don't know if I even know the show anymore at this stage. I'm that. And I'm there, I'm in it, and it feels so good. Kick it off and get it low, let my body steal the show. About to lose it, here I go, with the bang, bang. Every move I made, I could feel it was going well. It's a pretty incredible feeling. I'm 3 dates into my first ever solo tour. But it's not the only big and exciting thing that's happening. I'm also releasing my first ever autobiography. You do?
Cheryl, you know we got your book? The real copy. Have you seen it already? Have you seen it?
Yes.
Show Lise.
Oh,
this one.
Wow. It's Harrods, it says Harrods on it.
I know.
That must be your copy.
Nice.
Oh my gosh.
It's fresh. That's nice.
I love that.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, you look incredible.
Look at
book inside. It's got words and stuff.
Okay. I know Lilia wrote them.
No, but it's like real. Oh, wow, that's so cool. She's signing it to me, it's the first book for me.
To Lily, you know the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. LOL. Love you lots. Thank you for everything. Love me.
Keep calm and soldier on. I have heard many years of speculation, non-fact, untruths, other people's side of a story. A source said, a friend of Cheryl said, this was just my opportunity to see exactly, in my words, what I think, what I feel, and I can move forward in a happier way.
Got it delivered yesterday, straight away, so yeah. Hopefully get her to sign it for me.
Fantastic, thank you. Thank you.
I love your book. I read half of it. I read half of it last night. It's just so inspiring how you can just get back up and be so successful after having such huge lows.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
I always make an effort to meet fans and talk to them and saying things. I love it. It gives me as much of a buzz as it gives them.
What's your name?
Beth. There we go, lovely.
They are the reason I do what I do. They're my backbone. That's why I call them soldiers, because they are dedicated, loyal, fierce, protective. Everything you want and more from a supporter.
Soldier for life. Cheryl soldiers, woo!
So far on tour, we've played Belfast, Dublin and Nottingham, but now it's on to the big one. The London O2.
Oh, gee. Climbing your feet, a cup of tea with an egg on toast.
2 seconds, I just need to put your head outside. Okay. I'll take your food.
Get me head on your plonker.
Oh, my God.
Just your colour. Can I have a try, please?
Do you know that number plate says Shizzle?
I want to try. How do I start it? What do I do? Oh, bye.
Wait, supposed to break. Don't run it.
What? Move? Excuse me.
No.
Move.
This is the. Okay. All right. Put your feet on the black mark.
It says Shizzle on the number plate.
Where did that come from? Did you order that?
No, somebody must have got it as a gift.
You ordered it for yourself, didn't you? I've always wanted a little pink.
I'm going to get Trey with a blue one and race him up and down the corridors.
Yeah. It's not too bad, right?
No.
With Trey's knee finally on the mend, he's ready to get back on stage.
I'm doing 4 numbers just to make sure my knee doesn't break again. It was good to watch the show, to finally see what we do and how everyone performs and all that. But by the 3rd show, I was over it, and I'm like, okay, I need to get back as soon as possible because it looks like so much fun, and I want to be up there.
Having Trey back is a huge support for everyone, especially for the biggest show on the tour.
The London show always feels different because everybody comes from the label, your friends and your family. It just has a different vibe. Even the arena feels grander and it's new, and it's like where I come to see all the big stars. So it's where I came to see Jay-Z, Kanye, Beyonce, the big people I love to come and see. So it's crazy actually that I'm performing here alone. Doesn't it feel quite real? And it's scarier too.
Playing the O2 is a total dream come true, but performing in such a high-profile venue brings a whole new level of expectation.
I've been waiting like 3 years for this. I think she's just amazing.
Fans have travelled from different countries just to see this show.
We're coming from Holland,
from Amsterdam Schiphol Airport.
Yes.
And now we're going to see Cheryl.
Yeah, Cheryl. Amazing.
They're notoriously known for being a difficult crowd in London. You have critics, you have journalists, friends there. Everything you can think of is under that one roof.
This is such a renowned venue. I'm proud and I'm happy to be a part of it as well, man. I know she's gonna kill it tonight.
I'm determined to make the O2 the biggest and the best show I possibly can, so I've arranged for a surprise special guest to join me on stage.
How you doing, well?
Hey, hey, what's up, guys?
Good, man.
Yeah. It's gonna be fresh. I'm excited. Like, really.
It has to be fucking sick.
Have you heard the three words version? You're on the huge pyramid, singing to me. I'll be facing you, like, on the other stage.
So you have two stages. Damn, that's dope.
The show's sweet, and I think that's the draw. People are so tired of, like, pretentious and, like, superficial divas. And to see someone successful that's, like, your next-door neighbor and nice and sweet, she's a friend of the family, that's what Cheryl feels like.
Will is a great energy to have around. He gets how I'm feeling. He knows it's a big deal. But to him, it's not. It's like, we're gonna do this. Are you excited? You know, you get ready. And all he wants to do before we go on stage is gossip. He doesn't care that I'm about to do this. I'm preparing, I'm nervous. He just wants to gossip.
So yeah, I talked to David Joseph about your next thing. He was like, I like that. Did he take his clothes off? So then, yeah.
So it actually lightens the mood. And now I don't feel as scared as I thought I would. I'm just excited to get it going, to be honest.
About to go off.
But the O2 is still one of the biggest gigs of my career. And it's about to start. All of a sudden, it feels like, wow, this is really happening. Normally, I have nerves, clammy hands, but this time I have physical knots in my stomach.
Let's go.
Ain't nobody fucking with us!
Show who, show who, show who, show who! Let's go!
London! It feels incredible to be here in and amongst you all. I want to share this moment with a very special friend of mine. I met a guy at the club. I let him know I'm in love.
I told him you are the love of my life.
Have Will come was actually a really big comfort because I knew people would appreciate that he was there. Let's go ahead and say, I love you. The fact that he was willing to come all that way to support me was a huge deal. It just made it that little bit more special. I remember doing the support opening act for the Black Eyed Peas on their show and thinking, I definitely want to have my own arena show at some point. And now I've done it.
Soldiers, I salute you! How'd you think I feel?
hit the mat at the end of the show, and I just can't wait to get out there and see all those people that have been a massive part of it. There's people crying in the corridor, there's people congratulating.
Yeah!
There's people screaming. It's electric backstage. Everybody's on a high. Nobody wants to sleep. The adrenaline is in full effect. Solo at the London O2 and we smashed it. The pressure is finally off and it's time to party.
What's my drink tonight?
Shots.
Yeah.
Where's Whiskey Mist?
It's up here. It's right up here on the left.
Good. How the hell am I gonna get in here safely, honestly?
With me?
Because I went through quite a lot in terms of the media and painful stuff. I kind of do build up a wall, I suppose, whenever I say paparazzi or whenever I'm talking to the media, because it just feels like they're trying to... Their intentions are not always good.
Hey, don't do the door, babe. Stop.
Jesus, is it, Cheryl?
Take a deep breath. I feel half naked. They're going to try and get shots at me naked.
Okay, wait. We're not going to get able to get through there. They're not. They need to move back first.
When you see a picture of me getting out of a car or going into a restaurant or leaving a club, is one thing. You see the picture. You see the end result. The process is hideous.
You ready?
No, wait there, we need this.
I've got a couple of things. Let's go. What the heck is wrong with those people?
It's intimidating and it's uncomfortable, but you know what? I'm at that stage now where just move out of the way, let me get into the club so I can dance. You can stand outside and freeze for a few hours. I don't care. I'm coming to the end of my first ever solo tour, and there's just one city left to play. There's nowhere in the world I would want to be ending this tour on than Newcastle. It's where I dreamt I'd be doing this. It's home. I'm so proud of where I come from. I'm so proud that I'm a Geordie. We are very proud and supportive of our own. So if you're a Geordie and you've succeeded, you have Newcastle's support forever.
We love Shazza! Can we just say that? She's class. I don't know why I love her, but I'm obsessed with her.
Cheryl is amazing, first of all.
And she's a Geordie like us as well. Yeah. I absolutely love her.
When you see it, Newcastle, mm-hmm. You think of Cheryl.
Yeah.
Or Alan Deck.
Gaza. Is it Gaza?
No, I don't know. Yeah. I think he was a bad one, though, wasn't he, in the end?
No, he's all right. He's from Newcastle.
Yeah, he was all right for a while, then he turned a bit bad.
Everybody's there, you know, my family, people I grew up with. My mother's incredibly supportive, incredibly grounded.
Keep calm and calm down. Are you telling you?
There she is. Go and give her a big cuddle.
Oh,
yay!
You baby girl.
French.
Fabulous.
High five.
My dad was the one person when I was growing up that was trying to keep it real, like, get your head out of the clouds. Yes, you have a dream, but so does every other 14-year-old girl.
She's been telling us since she was about 4 what she was going to do, and none of us believed it. I said, stick in at school, because that's where you'll make your money, but obviously, what do I know?
And they're just all so excited and so proud. My dad always has this saying that he says, I'm so proud I could pop. And I knew he was gonna do that.
I
I just thought, what can we do to make it a bit more spicy for Newcastle? There must be something extra I can give, like do a big S1 dive. I think they loved it. I went blank in my mind, but everyone else on stage said they went crazy. They were giving me is overwhelming, actually, and I felt so good. Nobody was even remotely there to criticize or judge or look for anything other than having a good time and supporting and being proud of one of their own. And I could definitely feel their energy. It's the most bizarre feeling in every single part of us. It just felt overwhelming.
This is amazing. You know, it's crazy, when I was like a little girl, I used to drive past here on the bus and just hope and wish, and I had a dream, and I'm here.
Done it. It's complete. I did it. I miss all the stuff that happened, losing dancers, people injuring themselves, being terrified of reaction, you know, just everything came together and we were blessed to have a successful tour. And I'm proud of myself.
She was absolutely amazing.
And Nevi's a cool star. She was amazing.
I think I succeeded with what I set out to do. Have the fans have one of the best nights ever of just music and entertainment and mutual respect and love for each other. And I definitely got that tweet and I definitely got that message.
We've had such fun and it has been so amazing that you want it to continue. So, yeah, it's kind of sad.
Look at them all getting
Cheryl,
in their cars.
What,
I hope they're going to play the album when I get in there.
Let me.
I jumped off the end. Where did I go?
Where?
It's magic.
Who?
Magic.
Why?
Because I just disappear.
First contact.
And then I ended up here.
Next time I want to go on tour for a long time. We do 5 O2s, 5 Newcastles. Have more nieces and nephews there.
Smash, baby.
I would do this forever. For free. Don't hold us to that one.